If it be your will that I speak no more, and my voice be still as it was before, I will speak no more. I shall abide until I am spoken for. If it be your will, if it be your will, let a voice be true from this broken hill.
What was thrilling to me is that so many people love the work, that they not only found the iconic work interesting, but the new work that the hotel carries on, that artists, you know, from one decade to the other are still very creative. You know, people's heart are in the iconic, but, you know, we had Robert Mapplethorpe's brother here, you know, involved and interested in the new work, too. So this was great. Yeah, curating a show was a really powerful experience being a photographer because, you know, now I understand why people pick certain pictures, because I definitely had an idea, and then I was able to see why sometimes you go, but the curator didn't pick that, I don't know why, but I already had that picture or something like that, and you never really understood that. It was interesting to see the work as it came in. From different countries, from different time periods. So that was powerful, and I wanted to not only celebrate the hotel, but to celebrate the artist in the city and the power of this collective group that Stanley Bard helped to foster and that, frankly, that we're continuing through the global revolution, through the internet revolution. The fact of the matter is the photographic print, the hard copy, the wall, the intimacy, that is so important, and I hope that the show made a dent and a statement about that.
The magic starts for me in 71, when I arrived in New York and discovered the Chelsea and Shirley Clarke. Incredible woman, hysterical, more than I was. I couldn't believe it. Everybody was already dressing in black. Nothing had changed. The staircase is the same. The magic is still there. Shirley Clarke, then later I moved to LA where I gave birth to my son, and I was bored when I was pregnant. And I look and I see her name at the university. And I went and I took her class, and it was in a minute she was in my home doing a movie on my pregnancy, on the plant, on the pool. She was hysterical, crazy. I was a mother, a daughter, an aunt, everything. And it was really incredible. The class she was giving was really exciting and inspiring. But of course everyone thought she was totally mad. And then of course I met Martine Barra here. At the time she was doing an exhibit at the Whitney Museum, so I helped her. I remember I rent a car and I carry everything to Harlem, to the Whitney, to the Chelsea, back and forth, and she was also full of energy and authoritarian.
I moved from Paris, and I just somebody referred me to the Chelsea Hotel. I had no idea, and then they said, "Oh, it's going to be fantastic for you. You're going to fit in. It's a fantastic place where all the artists live, etc." So I moved in for 6 months, and I'm here still after 27 years. Why? You don't know. You think you check in a hotel and you're going to leave in a few weeks? No, this is like the place. You never know when you're going to check out. Anyway. So, and even Stanley asked me one day, "Mais là, when are you going to leave?" I'll say, I look at him and he look at me, "No, you want to die here? I said, yes, Stanley, I want to die here. So that was very great. Beside that, of course, I think this is really, the energy is very special. There is a really deep soul in the Chelsea, and every time I go, I was traveling a lot for my work around the world, and every time you come back in the lobby, you just feel like, it's like a meditation trip. You're peaceful. I don't know, even if it's chaotic walls and everything is happening, it was very peaceful for me. I think this energy is unique. They also say that I have a fabulous ghost to protect me next to my chimney. I don't know, but friends came and that's it. So I really want to keep these spirits here and this energy, and that's why I would like to really be in all the projects and collaborating in any project who really keep the Chelsea Hotel with the spirits alive in the art, in all the art, and any person who is not even an artist who live here, you know, to keep them going, I think. And actually, I don't know, have the experience, the positive experience that I have had for all these years. Yeah, I had great neighbors. Didi Ramon was my great neighbors. It was really great. We shared dog stories, his dogs, my dogs, on the balconies. It was really amazing. And there were quite a few. From a time, there was a gentleman, of a young guy, who was sitting in the lobby, and every night I was going out, partying, he was handing me a tarot card, and he said, this is for you, night. And it was really that, at the certain point, it was the codependence. I wanted to see if he was there giving me the cards for the good tarots for the night, to see how the night was going. There was one. Then there was the angel. He was always in the lobby and outside the Chelsea with his huge wings. That I don't know if he got those wings from a prop to the Victoria's Secret, one of those fashion shows. But for also a time, he was there. So he was like, the tarot's protecting us, the angels protecting us. So that's also was this thing's unique. You can't find this anywhere else beside the Chelsea Hotel. As an event planner, my service and my skill are pretty wide. So we all know as an event planner that you start to gather, you know, to find a spot, a special, unique location, and then you gather all the services you need to make a perfect parties, and to have the result, the unique result for your clients, you know, to make an unforgettable event. And